Psalm 10 verse 4, the wicked has no room for God. The wicked, the people of the world have no room for God because they don't know God. They don't know the power of God. They don't know what God has kept for them. ఈ లోకంలోనే ఉండి లోకపు సమస్యలతోనే ఉండి ఉన్నవారికి దేవుడు అంటే ఎవరు తెలియదు. దేవుడు మానవునికి ఏం ఉంచున్నాడని తెలియదు. ఆ దేవుని ఎలా పొందుకోవాలని కూడా తెలియదు. ఇఫ్ యూ డోంట్ మూవ్ విత్ ద స్పిరిట్ యూ విల్ బి మూవ్ విత్ ద ఫ్లెష్. దెర్ ఇస్ నో అదర్ వే, దెర్ ఇస్ నో ఎనీథింగ్ ఇన్ బిట్వీన్. ఎయిదర్ యూ మూవ్ విత్ ద స్పిరిట్ అదర్వైజ్ యూ మూవ్ విత్ ద ఫ్లెష్. యూ మే బి ఎ స్పిరిచువల్ మ్యాన్. Spiritual man is different. Being in the world, you can be a spiritual man, crying for God, seeking God, and teaching about God, all that, even doing miracle of God. There is a second stage. People of this world, the psalm very clearly says, the wicked has no room for God. That's what we read in 1 John chapter 2 verse 15. Do not love the world of what is in it, because if anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. He doesn't understand what is the love of the Father. He doesn't understand what is the power of the Father. He doesn't understand what is the dream and vision of the Father for everything in the world. There are three things will catch a spiritual man in the world. Though he is looking for spirit, he will be struggling with the three things. If you do not focus to heaven and move from heaven to the earth, what is left out is being in the world, look towards the heaven. If you don't move from within to out, you will be moving from out to in. Out means you are caught up. Now I am looking outside means now I am seeing all of you. Whenever I see you, I know what is about my son, about what is this son. I know about the thought of everybody comes by the time the thought of the spirit is gone. There are three things. If you don't catch with the spirit and the heaven, the earth will catch you with the three things. Number one, the craving of the flesh. Second, the greed of eyes. Third, the people boasting of their superiority. I know about this. I am coming from this caste. So many people say superiority with their caste. So many people think they are superior because they have money. So many people say they are superior because they are beautiful. So many people feel they are superior because they are talented. So many people feel superior because they are intelligent. Many people are tied up by Satan. Something it tells them, you are great enough. And they are, I am intelligent, I can survive anywhere. You are gone. Your door for heaven is closed by the door of the earth. Because you are caught up here. Some are with the greed of the eyes. Don't hold on to the world. That will pass away one day. He will give next shock. The world and not all its glory passes away. Papa. The third thing is the world and all its glory. Those who hold on to the world, suddenly they pass away. And those who do the will of God, they remain forever. This is the eternal secret, eternal truth, which is recorded in chapter 2, verse 17. When the eternal truth begins to live in them, as they have chosen, if they have chosen the spirit and up they move from heaven, they find greater life. And those who are cling on to the earth and they are trying to move to heaven, they don't reach neither heaven nor they move out of the flesh. I repeat, those who are trying to move from down, they neither move to heaven nor they move out of the flesh. They remain in the flesh they continue to cry to heaven. They go for preaching. At the same day, next day they go, they become a drunkard. They go for preaching, the next day they still live in the flesh. They don't give up the friendship with the world, but still they preach. Still they do miracles, wonders. So both are part. Suddenly a day comes, the grace moves away, the flesh that was working in you comes, the spirit of the evil. And that day, the moment spirit has left you, the enemy in front of everybody, he puts you down and humiliates you, and you become a zero man like Samson. God gave him a life of the spirit, anointed him and gave him the power. He moved with the spirit, and so much of power was manifested. He could catch 300 foxes. You and I cannot do. With the power of the spirit, he moved. He could do anything, carry anything, carry the very big iron gate, which is of the great walls, you know, and carry it to the mountain top and throw it away. Not easy, because of the power of the spirit. But he thought, I can bond with the spirit and live with the flesh. As the book of Galatians chapter 3 verse 3 says, hello my dear, how is it that you are born with the spirit and you have ended up with the flesh? Do you know where you are going? Then the second stage, he never realized that he has to throw away the flesh if he has to remain in the spirit. God reminded him twice, thrice. No, he didn't bother. Then the Lord's spirit left him. Judges chapter 16 verse 20. Samson did not know that the spirit of the Lord has left him. First time when the lady or the people tied him up, he could shook. And all the thread which was tied fell down. Second time, he shook. And it fell down. Third time, the lady removed the hair and the spirit left him, and she tied. He thought he will shook, but he could not shake. He did not know, only in the spirit you can overcome what the enemy ties you. Today you and I are living happily, protected by God, in spite of so many powers of evil that is attacking you. Do not know, each minute, 24 hours, evil is after you. You and I are protected because the spirit of the Lord is protecting us. Many people take the protection of God and the love of God for granted. You are not realizing which moment the spirit of evil is going to fire you, which moment it is going to throw you out and humiliate you, which moment he is going to make you zero and make you to in front of everybody throw you. People take for granted and they play with their flesh, play with the world, and they think nothing will happen to them. Because yesterday I could escape. Okay, so I can escape. Nothing will happen to me. That is the trick of the enemy. Kindly read the book of Sirach chapter 5. What are the seven tricks Satan will use, whereby he will make people to remain in the flesh and act like the men, people of the spirit. You will remain in the flesh and still you seek the spirit. You will say, array, so many people have sinned, man, nothing has happened to them. One more technique, he will say, array, now you are young, now it's okay. Chalta hai. Jab buddha hota hai, wo time dekh sakte. Wo time dekhenge. Abhi kya? Now you are young. When you are old, that time you can hold on to rosary, you can hold on to Bible, and that time you can hold on to breviary. Now what, man? Go here, there. The evil will catch you when you least expect, if you are playing with the flesh. So with the three things he will catch you. Number one, he says, the craving of the flesh. Number two, the greed of eyes. The eye will be watching many things. Why can't I get this? Why can't I take this? Why can't I possess this? Why can't I get harmonium? So nice. If I could only get this harmonium, it will be nice for me. If I get this shirt, it will be nice. If I get this money in my bank account, it will be nice. If I get that house, it will be nice for me in my name. You have to be very careful. Whereby you are robbed something precious of the spirit. Third thing is the people boasting of their superiority.